What's up, y'all? It's your boy Leonard Tumkulu. This is Movie Catch Up. Welcome to my channel. I'm Mr. Dapping Geek. You know, Movie Catch Up is basically a segment where I watch movies that played way back, didn't get the time to watch them, or like they out in digital HD. Like these two movies, they basically were out like digital. I think that the Superman was leaked though. I couldn't help myself. I'm sorry, but not even out yet. Is it? Because I saw a trailer recently and yeah, it's not out there, but I watched it. I couldn't help myself, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, I'm just gonna dive right in. This is Batman Ninja. Batman Ninja was phenomenal. Aesthetically pleasing, especially the character design. Did you see how Deathstroke looked though? He was my favorite character design out of all of them, honestly. Like, goddamn, he was so cool. And there were a lot of cool people. Penguin looked fantastic. Two-Face, Ivy, Joker, Batman, and the whole Bat family from Nightwing to... Oh fuck, even Red Hood. The homage to Japanese ancient culture was admirable. Like I jumped into a DC comic with some homage to Japanese culture, which I'm a fan of both. So this was a phenomenal. The story was kind of like mediocre and very predictable, but the only part that wasn't predictable in the story was that Joker and Harley moment where they forgot who they are. Even the animation changed that moment. So that was such a trippy moment for me. I was like, is this really happening? And it was. But then the flower made them remember, then found out Joker hypnotized. I did not anticipate that part. That part, if you predicted that part, you were fucking a Jedi mind trick motherfucker. But it was phenomenal. Yo, the way Gotham looked, the beginning and at the end of that movie, they could really do something with the series about this. DC streaming service, I hope you see this, like, this was phenomenal, like, it's classic how the Bat family just had to do hairstyles from that age, like, they even play homage to the situation. Another weird moment when Bruce cut, like, that weird thing with, like, a bad sign, when he was, like, a preacher, but then his hair was normal again. I was like, how did he fake that? Those are the only kind of nicky moments. Yo, let's talk about the bat suit, though. The technology Batman had in this movie, yo, the DCEU should take some pointers. Batman, this was weird, like a prepared Batman. Oh my god, he was so prepared. Like, goddamn, even with the fact that he got taken down and had to use, you know, the ancient Japanese look and whatnot, but still, at the beginning, he was so prepared. Like, the technology he had was just phenomenal. I give this movie like a 7 out of 10. Like I said, the story is a bit weak, but everything else is kind of phenomenal about it. The next movie is Death of Superman. Oh, this movie is phenomenal. I'm a big fan of the DCU. Despite Suicide Squad, Justice League, that whole background fiasco that ruined the movies that I expected to watch. Even though those movies are good movies, but I expected different movies because of what I've seen, what was promised. So I'm a little touchy about those two movies, but everything else I'm pretty adamant about, like Man of Steel, BVS Ultimate Edition, and Wonder Woman. Those movies are phenomenal. Fuck what you think, I love them. Anyway, even though I'm a fan of Batman v Superman and that Death of Superman story, even his resurrection in Justice League, but here they made it sit, y'all. Like, it had so much weight to it because of how much he was loved before, because of the supporting characters. Like, they gave him a genuine connection with a normal human being who was obsessed with him, who made up stories. Like, he was such a, like, admired. Like, BVS kind of took you off that because they made him a martyr, like a hated human being here. Not a human being, alien. Like, there were some people who loved him and some people who hated him. Yeah, it seems like everybody was on the same track on who he was, who he wanted, and put it more weight. Especially the digital age situation of it. The fact that, you know, everybody saw it through their phones, through their cameras. Even though I was like, it was such a digital age, but that woman still holding an old ass BlackBerry. But I was like, wow. Damn, and they went there. Doomsday done murked so many people. He almost killed the whole Justice League. Superman didn't show up and basically give his life, the whole league would have died, basically. And man, the fact that Superman is basically saving people and fighting this mecha indestructible. I hope we see him, because Zack did say Doomsday, I got that from BVS. I didn't need him to confirm it, that the Zod Doomsday was not Doomsday, Krypton locked away. And to think Apocalypse dropped that shit. Apocalypse dropped Doomsday. I don't know if you guys picked up on that. Like, that Apocalypse portal dropped Doomsday. They legit were cleaning ship, yo. They were, oh, that snap of the neck. Another BVS nod. I mean, DCEU nod. I mean, like, this movie is so connected. I was enjoying it so much. I hope it's a two-part, because I saw Superboy. I saw, like, a Superman Steel version. I forgot what is it called. Oh, I forgot his name. What else? I saw a lot of things start to happen. I hope this is two-part. I heard that it is. Hopefully they did not lie to me. So Superman come back from dead and his fortress of solitude also erupted. I hope that also happens in DCEU, because he didn't have it. He was using the spaceship to learn knowledge. Now, hope they give him his fortress. So please, a lot of OG fans and us, they can find a way. People are creative enough. This was a phenomenal movie. I give this movie like an 8 out of 10. Like, I would definitely watch it. It's short, but all of the New 52, like, DC Universe cartoon movies are this short, so I wasn't surprised, but it was so breathtaking. Like, the weight of Superman dying in this movie was crazy. It was crazy. I won't lie, it was better than. The weight of him dying was better than it was in DCEU, even though I loved that movie. It gave it a 10 out of 10. The Ultimate Edition. His weight here was bigger because of the supporting cast, Lois, his relationship. Like, everybody around him made this thing bigger. Even that slight moment where Batman was just like, had his fist up, then he just let it go. Like, it was just so much weight. You understand that, like, yo, that was a big moment. Where was Shazam, yo? I don't know, something that kept on popping in my head was Shazam. Was Shazam, was Hawkman, Hawkgirl, all these other people that kept on showing up. I was like, yo, where's Shazam, man? Is that dude in school? Anyway, subscribe here if you subscribe. Deuces.